a platform to sharing your thoughts.
Good afternoon, namaskar. Myself, Nisha Jalori, and on behalf of FOREM, today I am in conversation with two stalwarts of the wedding industry, Devika Narayan from Devika Narayan and Company, and Mahaveer Sharma from Sushin Events. Hi, Devika. Hi, Mahaveer ji. How are you all?
Good. Thank you.
Okay. A warm welcome to you both. It's such a pleasure to have the two of you here today, as I've had the privilege of working with both of you. Now, coming to it, as we all know that the world today is in the clutches of the COVID-19 pandemic. India itself is under a lockdown period of 21 days. And yet there is no clarity on whether this might get extended also. Now, what are the repercussions? Economy is shattered, business shut down. Even the wedding fraternity has had to incur huge financial losses. Now, the big question, how would you remain positive, or rather, how can you remain positive under such dreadful circumstances? We'd like to hear from you, Devika, first. What have you to say to this?
I think the lucky bit is this has happened to us at what is the end of one wedding season and the start of a second wedding season. So the good bit is this is in any case a time for us when we have a slight pause. Unfortunately, it's an extended pause. For me, the things that keep me positive these days are, I think this is a God-given opportunity to look back at our own processes, our own systems, and re-look at the way we run our business and our company and the industry. So what we are spending our current time doing right now is learning more, understanding, sorting our own systems and processes out. And in the hope that, to me, the world that we are going to go back to is going to be a very, very different world. The way we think, the way we perceive weddings, the way we perceive daily life is going to be different. The thought of me going out and having dinner or traveling seems like a time that was many years ago, when it was a few months ago or a few weeks ago. So I'm hoping that all of us spend this time in re-evaluating the way we are, the way we work. I think in the wedding business overall, we constantly move from one project to the other. Very rarely do we have times like this. And I think this is a great time for us to introspect. And that's the introspection is what is keeping me hopeful and positive that I will be able to come back as a newer person at the end of this lockdown.
Oh, wow. So that's really great. So Devika is all geared up, you know, gathering up energies to come back again with a bang. Mahavirji, what do you have to say to this?
I think
how to remain positive.
Yeah. So I agree with Devika. I mean, that's one good thing that has happened to the industry in terms of right around Holi when weddings don't happen. And, you know, we all were going to take a break. But I also, in addition to what she's doing, I also am trying to learn new things. I'm trying to read a lot, both online and offline. I'm trying to reach out to new people, new partners, look at new opportunities also. I think the medium or the future of the industry will change, at least short term, for the next 1 year, because people don't forget these things that easily. We don't know if it'll come back to the original about a year later, but for now, at least. Also, I think it's very, very, this has taught us a lot of things, how to save on travel, how to work under all circumstances, being productive online. So all these things are very, very important. And I think this has given us an opportunity to go forward. I also feel that people, while we will travel less, people will travel less also. So we'll have quite a few weddings that were happening outside of India, happening within India. So there will be a great opportunity. I think we should strengthen our creativity, our technology, our deliverables, our processes within India, make partners across the country wherever we are not or we have not worked earlier. Both hotels, both creative agencies, production companies, entertainment companies, etc., etc. I think this will go a long run. Also, I think this is a good time to redo your websites, redo your PowerPoint presentations, creating new designs. So keeping your team motivated for and work out in budgets that are easily workable, because budget, if there is a situation, you should be ready with a good creative for a lower budget. So all these things are very critical, and we should be pushing our teams to look forward to having a good season starting October, November for sure. And that is what is looking forward. And expanding your team, because now what will happen is every conference, every corporate event, every exhibition, 10 weddings will happen at the same time. So we'll have to split our teams. So you need to create more people, more partners, subcontract works for smaller weddings where you personally are not needed. All that needs a lot of positivity, time, and we have all of that, and we have to continue to work.
Oh, great. So both of you all are being very, very positive, and that is what we should be in this critical atmosphere around us, you know. So this too shall pass. Behind every dark cloud is a silver lining. These dark clouds will wither away and we will soon break free from the shackles of the deadly coronavirus. But what about the sad state of affairs at present? I just want to know, like now with the surrounding gloomy atmosphere, you know, around us, you know. So how should a wedding planner plan his upcoming crucial days now? Mahaveerji, you tell us, please.
I mean, as I said just a bit ago, crucial days are very, very important. I think in addition to creating, working on your presentations and creations and partnership, I think introspection is also important. So all of us have multiple verticals. We waste our time and energy and do whatever comes our way. So I think as a company, as an individual, as your team in all, I think it's very important to now understand what your strengths are, what your team's strengths are. Also look at why did you waste, you know, for similar time, you could do much more productive work. And you know, you see, introspection is very important as a company on a whole and individually also, to see which direction do you want to go. Do you want to outsource something? Do you want to have this in-house? This is your USP. So I think even I'm looking at analyzing, putting on energies, you know, for a do I need to do 50 weddings, 20 weddings, 5 weddings? I mean, do I need to do, you know, it's all of that that is also required. And I think introspection as leaders of our teams, as companies, is also important, in addition to improving our skills and abilities and presentations. And that's what I think I'm also doing while everything else is happening. And that is also, and it builds your confidence, it builds your strength. And that's what I'm doing also.
Oh, great. What do you have to say to this, Devika?
I think when we open up and go back to life after the lockdown, all our work is going to come to us in one go. It won't be spaced out. We would have lost out a whole bunch of months in between. So I think this is the great time to prep for that time. Train your teams. If you are in the design world, think of newer concepts, think of new systems, new processes, make your Excel sheets right now. Everybody you've met in the last year, 2 years, or 10 years, consolidate that information that when you go back to work, everything is handy for you. For me, this is like cooking. This is the time to pre-prep everything that the world is going to ask of you when we go back into it. And we have the time to do it. This is also the time to educate yourself, learn a new skill, learn new things. And so that when you go back, you are equipped to go back versus just sitting and feeling negative at this point of time. I think this time more than ever is a time for action.
Oh, that's really nice. So as what I have gathered from talks with both of you, you know, so it's quite evident that we are all set to bounce back again, you know, and everything is going to be back to normal. And we are surely going to come out victorious from this deadly coronavirus trauma, you know. Now, wedding is a field where budgets knows no bounds. People go all out of the way and spend unlimited, you know, to add glitz and glitterati to this D-Day. Now, since both of you have been part of the big, big fat weddings, now I just want to know that do you think these so-called big fat weddings will now be a thing of the past, a dream? Devika, you tell us now first as to what is your perspective on this.
I think weddings have been changing for a while now. It's been a slow change and I think the next few months are only going to accelerate it. I think the focus is increasingly becoming on smaller weddings, more functions at home, quality over quantity. And these are trends that have been there in the industry for the past few years. But I think it's definitely going to be what our future is going to be about. I do think that weddings are going to be there. People will always find a reason to celebrate. But I do think that destination weddings are going to take a hold for a bit. People are going to have smaller, more personal celebrations. And then I think once the world opens up again, once there's a vaccine that's available to us, I think the future will be with those who are vaccinated, who can travel. And that's when I assume we will be part of a new normal at that point of time. But I think for now, the focus is going to be on smaller celebrations, more quality, having your close people around you. And people will still spend. They will spend with, I think, a little more care now. They will spend on products they care about, on things they care about, and not just frivolous. I think the time for frivolous spend is over.
Oh, so you mean to say the weddings will now be more family-oriented?
Not just family-oriented. I think it's going to be more thought to a wedding now. It won't just be, koi bhi aa gaya, koi bhi le gaya, kaise bhi ho gaya. I think people are going to spend with a little more caution. People are going to want things with a little more restraint. And I think that is how the world should be moving forward. They're going to start caring about where things are coming from, the impact of the things they're using at the weddings, how they're spending their money, what they're spending their money on. I think these are the questions people are going to be asking.
I know. Everybody's going to take care, surely. Mahavirji, what do you have to say to this? The big fat weddings, are they going to be a thing of the past?
Well, you know, yeah, in the immediate future, not going to happen. I agree with Devika. In the near future, that is what's going to happen. And I think as the coronavirus progresses, you know, if we are in under, if this thing dies down in the next 2-3 months, we have at least a year of what she's saying to happen. Because, you know, we as human beings tend to forget. You know, when demonetization happened, similar conversations came about. People cut down on the budgets. I don't have money, blah, blah, blah. We were back to doing big weddings last year, a year before. So it's just a human thing or a psychological thing. Though I do agree, very sure, environment consciousness will increase. Health and safety will increase. Food will not be frivolous. Hygiene will be very, very important element in times to come. The structures, the physical recycling of products and designs or artifacts will be important. I think all these will play an important role in the times to come. I think the youth, the younger lot, which is going to get married, is being impacted far more by the, you know, and they are going to become conscious of the environment, health and hygiene, safety. Fun element will always be there, extravagance and showing off, because, you know, someone's wedding has happened in the family, which, and they spent X amount, the brother and the cousin have to do something similar, because it's not, you know, in India, wedding is a more perceptive than they are what actually people can afford or really want to do. They're more or less, I mean, every time I've seen the family and sit with the family, there are people who are feeling bad about spending so much money, but then there are people that they said, even if you wanted to, we can't do that. We have, you know, people are, I think India is a very, very difficult society. It is pushed by many people. Short term,
yes,
very, 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 very short. People have lost, people across all businesses have lost a lot of money or have lost at least 6 months of income. There will be shortage on cash flow. At least if this does not come back in the winter in any country or across the world, if this does not get revived and we actually have cures, I think from next summer on or a year from now, we should be able to go back gradually. Go back to how we did after demonetization, go back to big fat weddings. People will be making money. It might create opportunities for people. I mean, a dead business will now, you know, there are so many other business opportunities that are coming. So people will make money. It's inherent that Indian economy will bounce back. And I think it's just a matter of time. But short term, I totally agree with you. There you go.
Okay. So as both of you all say, that people are going to be more cautious and more aware, you know, towards their spendings. That's what you mean to say.
Absolutely, for now. Yeah.
Yeah. For sure.
Okay. Okay. So it's been a great discussion with both of you. Thank you so much, Devika and Mahavirji, for sparing your valuable time and joining me on this session. It's been really been great. With this, it's a wrap. Hum honge kamyab. Till then, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Citylive, a platform to sharing your thoughts.